To review a standalone VR headset you have not heard of but have pretty high specs, the Pico G2 4K right here. It is only 3 DOF, so not really for gamers, but with third-party application like Visbit, you can play up to 12K to 60 footage with its beautiful 4K LED display. Yes, I said 12K. This is not a mistake. The video color is more vivid compared to Oculus Go and the brand new Oculus Quest right here. Also, are you feeling frustrated teaching your clients how to use a VR headset the first time? You wish there's a magic button that when pushed, the video starts to play without clients moving around the VR controllers? In this video, I will show you why, as a business, you should consider the Pico G2 4K and the Visbit VR Player combo. Let's dive right in. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up, a YouTube channel dedicated to VR video content creators. If you want to learn the latest tech in cinema VR production, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Let's talk about the specs. Here are the Oculus Quest, Oculus Go, and Pico G2 4K spec comparison. The Pico G2 4K use Snapdragon 835 as CPU, just as the Oculus Quest, but better than the Oculus Go. The single LED panel has a higher resolution than both the Oculus Quest and the Oculus Go. Also, lots of people do not like the Diamond Pentel OLED display Oculus Quest use. It has less red and blue subpixel compared to the Go, which is a LED display, but Go have its own issue. You can read more about it on the link below. On the other hand, Pico G2 4K does everything right for VR video application. Again, if you are a VR gamer, stick to your Oculus Quest. Pico is not the headset for you. Check out this video instead. Just look at the glasses right here. The lens are so much bigger than the Oculus Quest or the Oculus Go, and it does not have any screen door effects, which is one of the key for immersive video. It breaks immersion faster than you know when you see a black frame on the corner of your eyes. In terms of comfort for long hour video viewing, the design of Pico G2 4K is brilliant. It is one thing that I absolutely love. Right here, the back part right here, it is the heaviest part of the entire headset. It is the battery. So when you wear it, the weight is evenly distributed and it will not cause neck pain, which is a side effect of long hours VR session with the Oculus Quest, a front-heavy VR headset. Another reason why lots of business is not investing in the Quest but instead stick to the Go. Causing your clients discomfort can sometimes mean losing that business deal. That is why businesses spend the premium on demo headset to give their potential clients the best VR experience ever. Another cool thing about the Pico is that the headset has all its control built around. You can control using view gazing instead of a remote control like right here. You have no idea how many times I lost my Oculus Go controller. One thing is kind of a bad design is the speaker. It is at the bottom instead of on the side, make the music sound a lot further. I would recommend using a noise-canceling headphone for the G2 4K. So, the Pico G2 4K has a better CPU, higher resolution LED display, and more comfortable wearing experience. But it is not cheap. The official price is not confirmed yet in the US, but it will cost around $370. That's not your only cost though. The Pico G2 4K comes with its own app community and also Vive Wave. Well, you are not a gamer, so the selection of VR games does not concern you. But its native video player is not as robust as Oculus Gallery. Lots of my H.265 compressed video are not playing correctly. So in order to have a seamless VR playback experience for your VR clients, who is going to give you lots of money for creating their VR video contents, you want a better software solution. Here comes Visbit, a VR player already well known in the professional VR community. Visbit had a new update on Vive Wave that will leverage all the available pixels on the Pico G2 4K to display 10K to 60 video and 12K with a zoom feature that allow you to zoom for details. You know, sometimes your VR video just look too far and your clients always want a tighter shot to maybe showcase their logos. Well, there is no tighter shot in VR, and most of the time that is your only shot. With the zoom in feature, it solved that problem. Although you do need a 11K or even 12K VR camera. Well, check out the Insta360 Titan review right here. Another big problem is teaching your clients who never use a VR headset before how to pick the floor level and draw their safety boundary with the Oculus Quest. All you want in a trade show is someone pick up the headset and the video start to play without them or you doing anything. We call it the Kiosk mode. There is also an important mode called theater mode you should learn about if you are running a VR theater. Check out this video right here. Visbit Player allows you to do both, but it is not cheap. In fact, pretty expensive. I don't blame you if you stop watching this right now, because most of you probably don't need this kind of fancy feature. But if you want the absolute VIP experience for your client showcase, and if you are running a very important trade show, let's keep watching. We are going to get technical here. Warning, this part is pretty heavy with numbers. If you don't care how Pico G2 4K or any VR headset can deliver 12K resolution, skip ahead with this time code. Okay, I put on my professor hat. Oh well, I can't find my professor hat, so I put on my Attack of Titan hat instead, because this cool professor like anime. Okay, how come Pico G2 4K with Visbit can do close to 10K and other headset can only do 6K even less? Well, for foveation technology, this allow VR headset only display high density PPD, pixel per degree, where the viewer are looking. Learn more about it in this video. But even with the foveation technology and projection optimization, the resolution is limited by the headset physical display. First, FOV of most HMD are around 90 degrees horizontally. You may see a higher number like 100 or so, but that is diagonal. Confusing marketing statement, huh? Two, 12K video equal to 32 pixels per degree. Three, Pico G2 4K has a resolution of 1920 per eyes. So number four, average PPD of Pico divided by 90 is 21.3. Number five, higher center density. In VR, images are distorted on the screen. See screenshot right here. So that the lens will undistort the distortion. See the line are bent and the pixel in corner are more compressed than the center ones. The Pico higher center density is around 50% more. So we get 21.3 times 1.15 is 24.5 PPD. If we assume a 1x1 pixel mapping, Pico G2 4K saturate at the resolution of 24.5 times 360 is around 8,820 pixels. 7. Visbit overfit around 10% more pixel for higher sharpness while keeping aliasing low enough. Again, watch this video for overfit pixel concept. Then do the math. 9702 is arguably the ideal resolution here, which is 10K without zoom. Number 8. Visbit has zoom feature which allow user virtually move 2 times closer to the pixel with half of the FOV. With the VR zoom feature, you can see around 19K of details. It's actually more than 12K. Whew, lots of numbers, but there you go. We figured out 12K number together. Okay, no more professor here. Well, in reality, how much better? Let's take some screenshot and check it out. Here we have a screenshot in Oculus Go. Then we have a screenshot of the same video in Pico G2 4K with a Visbit player. Now I put them side by side. You can immediately tell Pico G2 4K has a larger FOV. I highlighted a detail area and zoom in 300%. You can read the text bar on the Pico version, but not really in the Oculus Go version. Also, you see fewer compression artifacts on the Pico version. And also the skin tone looks more natural due to the extra color calibration Visbit does on the headset in use. It shifts the red and blue color more on the peripheral area to compensate the light reflection for different color through the lens. It may look worse in screenshot, but it will look much better in the headset. An extra feature Visbit does to make your footage look better. Now, let's take a look at the zoom feature on Visbit. Now, distant detail looks even better. It is kinda like a 6DoF experience with the zoom. Give you an entirely new level of information that Oculus Gallery or any other player does not offer. I have to warn you, if you do not capture your 360 videos in at least 10K in sensor level, none of these are useful to you. Stick to your Oculus Go right here. But if you have a custom rig that can do 12K or the brand new Insta360 Titan that can do 11K in monoscopic, then you should consider Pico G2 4K and Visbit combo.
Well boys, we did it. Low resolution 360 videos no more.
Thank you so much for sticking around. If you are still here, you just become smarter than most of the people in the 360 world. So congratulations. Now you can argue with your camera technician over a pint of beer because you just learned that from your boy Hugh. Again, this is the last step of your entire pipeline, the delivery. It is not going to be useful if you mess up somewhere doing stitching, editing, or post-processing. So make sure you check out my other 360 post-production tutorials and follow the best practices. In the next video, I will review a native 8K VR headset with a 4K display, the Skyworth VR headset. It has a powerful chipset that can just play 8K video straight up, and it's a cableless standalone VR headset. So don't forget to subscribe and give this video a like. Thank your boys Hugh goes above and beyond to educate you to become a better VR content creator. And I will see you next time. Thank you.